it is that. Well, this is the last racer on course at 109.108. Just ahead of him from Peru is climbing back up. This is Manfred Mortel Reyes, the Peruvian entrant for this men's giant slalom. His second games, looking to improve on his 67th position. I'm not sure that would be the case, but by hiking back up and going through that gate, he guarantees himself a second run in 78th position. Now we'll get back to the last racer, number 109. Oh, what a shame for the Venezuelan Antonio José Pardo Entretta.
He's had some trouble here. We'll have a look at it.
Pardo Entretta, the 43-year-old from Caracas. Oldest man in the competition. Both bindings release. He's actually the president of the Venezuela Ski Federation. A very difficult racetrack out there today, and understandably so, the frustration clearly shown. Binding had released before he got the ski into the rut. Down he goes. Ted Ligety dominates the first run of the men's Olympic giant slalom here in Rosa Couture. A surprise but a pleasant one to see Andre Bank, the Czech Republic, in second spot. Simon Celi is in the bronze medal position. Benjamin Reich, the Olympic giant slalom champion of 2006, is in 13th spot. Jan Trudt, silver medalist from 4 years ago, is in 16th, but the Norwegian already has a gold from the super giant slalom. Bodie Miller, 26th position, will have the advantage of the smoother track as we flip the top 30 for the second run, with both run times added together. Ted Ligety almost a second ahead of his closest rival. Could he quite possibly coast the second leg and still take the Olympic gold in giant slalom? The American double world championship gold medalist is looking very good to add the Olympic giant slalom title to his ever impressive list of results in this, the giant slalom discipline. A lot of racers found the going very tough on the first run, the steep pitch of Bear's Brow, and the late jump taking a lot of casualties in this competition today. And a start list of 109 on the first run will be dramatically reduced to the second. Only 79 racers will qualify for that second leg, and as we said, the top 30 will go in reverse order. These are the skiers that didn't make it, including one or two of the pre-race favourites, Didier Defargo and Marcus Sandel, with bibs 13 and 26. Will be disappointed not to have made the cut or the shake-up in the second leg. If the athlete has a DNF against his name, he will not be invited back to contest the second run of this men's giant slalom competition to be held here in Rosa Couture later today. Disappointment for Stefan Lutz of Germany.